Hi painters, it's Carrie here and Lemmy the bird, and we're back for another tutorial. Today we're painting a horse. I'm actually teaching this in my class tonight, and there was a couple of things about this painting that I wanted to run through to see if it was going to work, so I'm actually just kind of practicing for class tonight. But I'm starting from point A so you can actually see how I prepare for a class. So the horse tonight, which most of the animal paintings will have a stencil for. And so what I have here is a piece of drawing paper that I've cut to the size of a canvas, and I'm going to sketch out the horse first. So I want to do this on video so you can see how I do it, to get ready for y'all in class in case you wanted to paint it by yourself. The sketching is not a really hard thing to do, but people are often very intimidated by sketching. But it's easy if you break it down into simple shapes. So I'm going to tilt this slightly. I know that's not the best angle for you, but it's better for me to draw. And I look at my picture and I try to position on the canvas where is the center point, which the center point of this horse is going to be somewhere under her eye. So I'll find the center point of my canvas, and I know that the eye is going to be slightly above that at an upward angle. So I'm going to start with that. I may change this later. I usually end up erasing and making things bigger, but this is a good point to start. So I have, it's basically like a lemon shape. It's kind of upward turned. Now, below that, we have to get that cheek idea. So it's a good idea to just kind of make a circle. Just a circle, just to kind of, the horse has a very muscular cheek here. So I'm just kind of circularly so I can get that in my head where that shape is. And then it'll come straight up from that. Okay, so she has all these flowers on her head, so I'm going to deal with that later. Right now, I'm coming down from this circular point here. I'll make this a little bit darker so you guys can actually see it. This curve here. And then it comes down into her snout, goes downward. And the shape at the bottom here is kind of angular, like near. Like boxy, I don't know what I want to say. Like a hexagon. I think it's a hexagon, Lemmy. But a soft hexagon. So like this is the bottom of her chin. She's actually got a smile line here. You gonna spill the water already? Flat kind of at the bottom and then angles upward. And that'll be like the top of her snout, which shoots straight up like so, and you can see that an eye socket over here that kind of protrudes a little bit, and you can just see a little darkness over here to where that's an indicator of her other eye there. And that's a pretty good shape to start with. I feel like you're pretty on target there. She's going to have a big flower here. Again, I'm just doing rough shapes now. I can change all this if I want to. A circular flower here. A more full petally flower. And then another circular flower over here. Okay. I'm not going to do the leaves. They can add those leaves later. Above this flower, which you want to keep in mind of your proportion here, so it's right above this eye socket. It really doesn't protrude out much more than that eye socket. There is going to be the ear up here, and then there's going to be like the top of the head here, and you got another ear that is, again, looking at the eye, goes straight up from the eye, and that's kind of where that ear starts. And then you can just see a hint of her back up here. We're going to be adding a lot of greenery and extra little stuff up on top. But the idea for mapping it out is just getting the key points of our painting. What is the most important? So, I think we are pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and give a line right here just so they know where that neck is. And a little bit of line down, just an indicator of her shape. Now, the fun thing about this one is there's a lot of fun abstract stuff. I don't want to go out this far with it because we're going to need a little bit of space. I actually think she's not very centered. I want her over just a little bit, which is fine. I think I'm going to cut off that edge there. Oh, we got to do the nostril. The nostril, I'm just going to do a semi-circle down here. A little indicator of the other nostril over there. I'm pretty good with that. And like I said, you can kind of change things up a little bit as you go. If you decide you don't like certain parts of it, just switch it up. You're not committed to it. That's why I'm sketching it out first before I paint. And even if you paint it, you're not fully committed to it, because we are painting with acrylic paint, so you can change it. So now what I have is the graphite paper, and this is what my artists do in class when we have a sketch. It's basically transfer paper that will allow my stencil to be placed on the canvas. It makes it a little bit easier so they don't have to sketch it out. So that's what I'm going to do. Of course, at home, you don't need to do the whole transfer thing. You can sketch it directly on your canvas. But I'm doing a little test because I'm going to have them paint the entire background of the painting. And I want to see if we're going to be able to see our transfer lines if I paint over it. So I'm doing a little trial and error. I don't usually practice my paintings for class, but I want to make sure that this is going to work before I get to class today. Key points here. I think I got them all. Alright. So, I'll play with that more later. I'll trace a few more so we have some that they can stencil for class tonight. So, got a pretty good map out of our design. Now, let's talk about colors. Again, this is done in the style of kind of like watercolor, so it's going to be very, very dainty with our colors. But, of course, we're going to need white. We're going to need a lot of white, so I'm actually going to do a big white, and then I'm going to do a little white that I can keep clean for later. We're going to have just a little bit of black. I'm going to do my horse colors, and you can use any brand for that. Just a tiny little bit of black. There's not a whole lot. And brown. Again, these colors you can get in any brand of paint. I'm using Anita's from Hobby Lobby, and I'm also using CraftSmart from Michaels in the black and the brown. And for those colors, I don't really worry about the brands. Like, there's your basic colors, the black, the white. Brown is pretty basic. But the prettier colors, I always go with a more expensive brand. Americana is my favorite. And in Americana, I'm going to be using Tuscan Red, which is a very rich, true red color. I like it a lot. And I'm using Peony Pink, which is a pink, but it has a lot of red tones to it. I like that a lot. That's also Americana. I'm using Cadmium Orange. These are all my flower colors. That's also Americana. And I'm actually using Folk Art, a French cut grass. Fresh cut grass is the color that I'm using in Folk Art. And Folk Art's a really high quality paint. It's a little thicker than Americana, actually. And grass green and Craft Smart. So those are your colors for this painting. Now, the background on this guy is white. And I have this pet peeve. I think it's a pretty basic rule of painting that you have to paint the entire canvas. So this canvas is treated with a gesso, but it's not paint. So you want to have paint on every inch of your canvas. And to do that with a background that's white is kind of tricky because you can't see it. But I don't like to ever use just white for my background. I always add a little color to it. And when I say a little color, I mean a little color. There's a million shades of white. So what I'm doing is I'm taking just a little bit of brown on my brush and I'm mixing that with my white paint. Now, I don't want brown, I want white. So I'm just doing just a little bit. So when I paint this on here, you guys, it's going to look like white paint, and that's what I want. But it's actually a little off-white. Now, since I have the transfer on there, and this is my test, I want to make sure that they're gonna be able to paint their background without interrupting their lines. So the idea of this is I want them to use quite a bit of water with their paint and be able to go right over their lines and still see them. And so far, it's working really well. Yep, I think that's gonna be just fine. So that was my test for class tonight. Now, they're not gonna be able to go too crazy with it, but I'm dipping in my paint, or my water quite a bit, watering it down. When you paint with acrylic paints, you wanna definitely have a nice ratio of paint to water because the acrylic paints are a thick paint, especially the more higher quality ones. I'm working pretty quickly. And again, I just want to get a base coat on here so I don't have to worry about getting paint on my entire canvas. That's already done for me because this painting actually does not take much paint at all because it's in that watercolor style. So it's a really delicate painting. And I'm loving this. I'm able to go right over those lines that I created and still see them. Going in all the different directions, make sure I get the entire canvas covered while it's still wet. Oh, almost spilled my water. It wouldn't be you this time, Lemmy. Okay, so that's pretty good coverage there. I've gone over it several times. Can still see my guidelines. You may not be able to. I don't know how the lighting is, but I'm feeling pretty good about that. All right, so with watercolor, with the watercolor style, I don't really have to wait until it dries because I want it to have that watery effect. And the first thing that we're going to do is paint our horse. So I think what I'm going to do is start dark to light. I'm going to get Lemmy a brush he can play with so he doesn't destroy those ones. Here you go, Lem. And there's another one. And I'm going to get him some water because I forgot. You want some water, buddy? There you go. All right, sorry about that little intermission there for Lemmy's beverages. So the first thing that I am gonna work on is the dark points of the painting, which I'm gonna start with the eyes, and I never ever do that. I always make them wait until the end for the eyes. But I'm going to start with the eyes here because it's such a delicate painting. So nothing is going to be pure in color. I'm going to mix a little bit of black with my background white mixture that I have here. And I'm going to start start with that eye there. So I'm gonna just start with that upper lid, just kind of flare it up there, and I'm gonna fill in her dark center of her eye. I'm using my little brush because I want just different texture there. I'm actually going to take just a little bit of brown and put that in there with it so it has a little different tone. I'm going to take brown for the under part of the eye and add a little bit of color there. Under part of the eye goes around. It's actually like a double layered line there. And I'm going to add some dark shading around that. I'm going to switch to a little bit bigger brush for that dark shading. And I'm just adding a little bit. I'm using that background that's already a little bit wet. And it's just a tiny bit of paint at a time. I mean tiny, tiny, tiny paint at a time. Just under there a little bit. Just starting with some dark tones around that eye. Very, very lightly. You can use your finger to kind of smear it. I'm a big fan of finger painting. And you can see how just a little bit of color goes a long way. And we want it to be very delicate and not very dark. So I'm gonna go away from the eye a little bit. And this eye kind of has a path of going downward like so. And then into this cheek area where it gets really dark. And it goes all the way around and up into the flowers up there. So I'm just moving the paint that I already had on there and just blending it into that to where it's really light. Okay, so it's just the trick with this is just a tiny little bit of paint at a time. I'm going to go down and follow this line down into the chin there. That's where it's going to be darkest. I'm not reloading my brush. I'm just using whatever's left on there to just kind of shade that line a little bit. Down in this chin here. Again, just very little paint. That's the key. Very, very little paint. I'm kind of blending with my finger a little bit. Add a little bit more paint and come around this top of the nose here. And that line goes straight up into her forehead, but there's not a whole lot of shading over here. So I'm going to start with the shading down here at the bottom of the nose because I'm just going to use the paint that's on my brush here. And that comes up into like a triangular shape there. Works its way around to that mouth area. A little bit on the top and then just kind of drag that up over top of that line just to add a little bit, but not a whole lot. Whatever's left on my brush, I'm going to do a line in the center here for dimension and then another line right here. Just very, very lightly. It's not heavy at all. Adding a little bit more. You play music? I don't know if you can see this, but Lemmy is ramming his beak up against the glass that I gave him his water in. I'm going to use a little bit of a little bit more paint up here to just kind of highlight that eye socket over there where that second eye is going. And I'll just take a little bit under these flowers here. Still very, very, very light and delicate work here. A little bit more. This is coming down onto the neck area. Of course, the horse has a very muscular neck, so we got to kind of define some of the muscles. Add a little bit of water to my paint now because my background is dry. Just a little muscle tone for that neck. And I'm going to come up here and add a little brown just because that is the back of her neck up there, and a little bit up here in the ear area, just very, very lightly. A lot of water with my paint. Very, very delicate, soft painting this is. Okay. And I'm liking that. That is a nice start to that. I'm going to come back. Well, actually, no. I'm going to do a little bit of this hair here. Now, it's an impressionistic piece. So, it's not what I would say National Geographic photography. It's not a realistic piece. It's not supposed to be. So, apparently, she has some hair that's swooping over, probably from the other side. So, I'm assuming that hair is flipped over on the back and coming around her neck here. So we're going to start right here under her chin into this muzzle area. And I have my big brush. I'm going to line up my big brush with that line right there. And I'm going to just sweep it down in a real light sweeping motion here. And what I'm doing is I'm giving the indication of some hair that's coming around from that other side there. I'm gonna just do that line real quick. And I'm gonna do the same thing with a little bit of gray. I'm doing it very lightly. I kind of start like that, but then I kind of turn my brush so I can get a little bit more hair-like texture to it. While I've got that gray on my brush, I'm just going to kind of give the indication of that hair that's rolling over the back there. Okay. A few little swoops of hair there. Take just a little bit more of that dark color just to redefine the bottom of this cheek here in this. Just to darken it up just a little bit more for a dramatic effect. And a few swoops of hair that must be out of place. Okay. And that gray color that we're going to use, it's a gray, brown, white mixture, is going to fill in these ears up here. Just a little of that tone in the ears. We do not have to fill it in perfectly. Just giving a little bit of color to that. It's very simple. It's supposed to look like watercolor, not perfectly blended. Okay, and I'm going to take that color and I'm going to go inside this nostril with it. And on the other side here. Add a little bit of white to it and swoop all the way around with a little bit lighter color. There. Take a little bit more of that black-brown combo and darken up that mouth a little bit. I'm liking that. That's a nice start to a very light watercolory horse design. A little bit more color up in here behind the neck. Okay. All right. So that is our watercolory horse. We're going to go to our flowers. Well, the flowers are also very loose and fun. I'm going to start with the greenery, and I'm going to use a combination of both of those greens there, that fresh cut grass and grass green. And I'm going to start with just some greenery, and you can just kind of do very loose interpretations of leaves coming out of these flowers there. Just kind of wiggle my brush around until it looks something like a leaf. And comes right on top of my design in areas where I want to cover. Some leaves are bigger than others. That one up there is going to have a hard time covering, so I just add a little bit of white to it, and the white is going to add that opaque quality that will allow it to cover the background. Okay, a few more leaves down here. Stamping the leaves on some little viney things. Okay, I think that's probably enough greenery. I might add a little bit more, I'm not sure. And then I'm going to start with my flowery colors. So, let's start with some red. There's a lot of red that's going to come around the center of this flower here, so I'm going to start with that. And it's basically just about playing with your colors. Don't try to make these things perfect. It's all about color. It's all about soft texture, because we're still doing that watery color thing. This one I'm just going to kind of start in the center and branch it out. I think I need a little bit more water on my brush. Just kind of building it up with colors. I'm going to come in with some other colors, but playing with your flowers. So maybe swoop around the outer edge there. But again, just like the horse, this is not National Geographic photography. This is meant to look like art. It's watercolor art. Add a little bit more white to this and start with this rose, which I'm going to just make this rose a series of parentheses shapes, just turning my brush in parentheses shapes to make that. Adding a little bit of orange, a little bit of white, and this one is, forget what those are, that might be a peony. A little bit of pink, I need more white. I want it very delicate. And I'm just spinning that around. If you notice, I tried to make this one of the petals from this flower, and I changed my mind. That's not what that is supposed to be. It's supposed to be this little peony here. I'll take a little bit of that color and just throw it into the other flowers, because why not? Clean my brush off and go back to my pinky tones. Bits of color, bit by bit, back to the red, real dark center on this one, and some strong color. And the more you go over it, the darker and the more defined things are going to become. And it's a layering thing when you're painting in the style of watercolor. It's about layering very delicately. I'm going to add just a little bit of brown to some of that red. Get a real intense middle to this flower. And a little bit of brown. Maybe a little, just a teeny tiny bit of black. And get another dark tone in the middle of this flower. Okay. I know that there is no flower here, but I so feel like there should be. So I'm adding one. I'm just going to add a hint of a flower kind of hidden behind here. I felt like it needed that. aren't, of course, I'm not worried about covering all of this white. I can use the white background because it is in fact paint, because we paint the whole entire canvas white when we started, so we know it's already painted. So we don't really have to worry about covering the entire canvas. The entire canvas is already covered. Squiggly lines and fun stuff. Okay. Now, in these flowers, there's a series of little dots. So we're gonna start with black. I'm using the back side of my brush here, dipping it in the black paint. And I'm gonna do these little polka dots that are in the middles of these flowers. Some of them have them kind of around the outer part of the center. And some of them have them in the center. Okay, while we're doing the white dots, we need to add a couple white dots to our horse's eye. That wakes her up a little bit. And there are some little droplets of paint. So in order to do that, I'm going to show you. We're going to get rid of the easel. And we're going to lay our painting down flat. What I want to do is take, you can use different size of brushes, but I'm going to start with my medium brush. And what I'm doing is I'm going to water down some brown paint, some black paint, let's see, and some of this orange paint as well. I add just a little bit of white into that orange. Okay, so I've watered it down on my plate here. Mixed it up really good, and I've got little parts of watered down paint here. Now, the reason I want it really watered down is because I'm not painting, I'm dripping. So in the original, they have little drips down in this corner and then up in this corner. It just adds a little artistic effect to it. So I'm gonna start with the black because that's the one that's really scary for you guys. And I'm gonna hold it above and I'm just gonna squeeze my paintbrush. Didn't get enough paint on there apparently. Squeeze my paintbrush until it drips. Hold it up a little higher and it splatters differently. It's got a couple black drops on there. It's kind of tricky to squeeze. Okay, so I got a couple black drops on there. Clean that off. I'm going to go into my orange. Do the same thing. And those are pretty big drops, so what I'm going to do is switch to a smaller brush now and get some little smaller drops. Of course, my fingers are getting all kinds of messy, but it's okay. And you can kind of flick your brush over to get smaller droplets. To the orange again. What you doing, Lem? Bigger drops. So this is a pretty pretty easy painting because it's not supposed to be real realistic. A lot of the ones that we do are super realistic looking, and those take a little bit longer. This one is really about fun, artistic look to it. Can you get this orange to drop? There's going. Okay. So I want that to just set for a second, because if I tilt it up right now, it's going to be all over, running down. And just because I love the speckling, I'm just going to add some more. Let that dry for just a second. I guess I can give you a sneak preview of what that's doing when I do that. So, and a closer view of the painting. So zooming in on the beautiful Lemmy bird. Say hi, Lem.
Hi, Lem. What are you doing? What are you doing, pretty boy?
Who's so pretty? Who's a pretty bird? Who's a pretty bird?
Lemmy. Hi, baby.
Okay, that's enough Lemmy talk. There's a sneak preview of the water droplets while they're drying, and a little closer up of the horse. So it's very simple. It's very loose brush strokes, very simple. And you can build on that a little bit more, which I think I will. I'll probably add a little bit more definition to it. Let's see if I can line that up again. Technical difficulties. Why don't I want to stay? Huh. It worked before. Should not have moved it, I guess. Okay. I think that's going to work. So, still, that water takes just a little bit to dry. It's a lot slower than acrylic paint. If I'm being impatient, which I am, I can just absorb a little bit with a paper towel. I would just put a paper towel in the center of it, and it'll sop up some of that and make it dry faster. And that's what I'm doing because I'm being impatient. Dry a lot faster. Again, it'll dry eventually if I just set it there, but it's taking forever to dry, and it's because there's a lot of water in the paint, and that slows down the drying process. So, just sop up some of the water. Oops. Every towel. Easel back. Now that I got that water on there, it shouldn't run. Might run. Shouldn't. Okay. Clean my brush real quick because I got a little bit get rid of that. We're gonna blend it down a little bit. her painting, and it's pretty spot on to the original. I'm sure you can't see that from there, but I'll show you that in the clip. But I'm going to just do a couple things. I always like to look when I'm finished painting and add a couple things to make it better, and that's the highlights and the lowlights. So I'm just going to go through and just add a little bit of white to these flowers up here, just to add another layer of complexity. Anytime, like the more steps you can add, the better. A little in the leaves, a little in there. And then I'm gonna add some low lights, and that's gonna be a little bit more definition to things like the key points of my horse. So that's definitely gonna start with the eye. I'm gonna add, I got just pretty much black on there, so I'm gonna add just a little bit of harsh black here just to add a little bit more intensity to her eye there. I think the eye can be a little bit stronger. Just for dramatic effect. And she's got a little bit of eyelashes up in this corner here. I really don't like the way they're going because they're going up like cartoon horses. So I'm going to actually take them down like I think they need to be. Like so. I like that. That helps. Helps with dramatic effect there. Everybody likes the long eyelashes on these animals usually. A bit more black in that eye there. Bit of paint at a time just to add a little bit more depth. Do the same thing down here, just kind of adding a little bit more depth at the key points. And there's not a whole lot to this painting. It's pretty simple. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Got to do that whole other eye over there. So you can't see the eye, but we want to do a dark indication of like there is another eye over there. So it's really just the kind of a squiggly little line there. It says, yep, there's another eye over there, but we can't see it because her head's turned. And go with my smaller brush and add just a couple more strands of hair. I'm going to call her finished. So, thanks for joining. Wish me luck on tonight's class. I think it's going to go awesomely. These animal ones usually do. And this one, there's not a whole lot of steps to. So, again, the main focus when we're doing these ones is just tiny little bits of paint, I think, and very light-handed brush strokes. Just grazing our canvas lightly with our hand. Don't be harsh with it. No harsh brush strokes. It's very, very light. Slightly building. It's like, I always make the comparison to adding blush, like if you're blush or bronzer when you're doing makeup, it's easy to add a little bit more, but it is hard to take it away. And that is when we do these watercolor style paintings. It's the same concept. You can always go back and add a little bit more, but taking it away is harder. You have to paint over it. So. she is. I'm gonna name her Sequoia. Thanks for joining me.